know more such amazing stories from Indian history, click the bell icon and subscribe to Live History India.
This is a Saturday morning congregation in Bandra. People are here to enjoy the works of a 15th century poet Kabir, who lived and penned his classics in Varanasi centuries ago. The annual Kabir Festival aims to bring to life the works of this bhakti saint. Whose words hold true even today. This initiative is the brainchild of a Mumbai-based non-profit Sahej Foundation, which is bringing Kabir alive. The festival brings artists and performers from across the country to the city of Mumbai. We spoke to Falguni Desai, a practicing lawyer who coordinates the event with a team of volunteers.
In this country, we have a very rich tradition of spirituality, which has broken the boundaries of organized faith to seek a connection with within and without, and with the divine. And these poets have spoken in difficult times, you know, in times where there was need to speak against caste, against dualities of religion, and these voices are important. They are voices which matter in our times as much as they mattered in their time. We still live in difficult times in India. And this is a way of breaking those boundaries, doing away with those dualities.
Mumbai's Kabir Festival completes 10 years this year in 2020 and is completely volunteer run. Interestingly, even though the very first festival was sponsored by a corporate, the festival organizers say that they have actively avoided corporate sponsorships since then, going in for a more crowd-funded model.
First festival was funded by the Mahindras, and you know, while it had the same kind of spread across the city, we just felt that we wanted to, if the real value of what we are doing, the value of trying to reach out and connect people, was in joining. Is hum logo ko jod sake is marfat ke, that they join with us in making this festival happen. People really appreciated what we did and people started contributing to us. It's a fully volunteer run. It's always been fully volunteer run, but the community funded part happened slowly, but it's now fully community funded. The other very big part of making this festival possible is associations. So we've associated with many organizations like Seher, Comet Media Foundation, Kitab Khana, all of them have offered us their space.
The festival itself is not limited to one enclave of the city, but in fact, the events are held all over, which makes it inclusive and very accessible. And even the artists themselves come from across the country every year in the month of January.
The idea is because the city of Mumbai is very difficult to traverse. We try and do events across the city. So we have events from Fort till Borivali to Ghatkopar. We try to reach as much of the city as possible so that everybody can get something of it. Many of our artists come from very rich oral traditions where the poetry has been passed down through the word of mouth. It hasn't been recorded, it hasn't been written down. India is a country of oral traditions, where much of our culture has been passed down orally. So we have Parvati Baul, who was there, Muralala ji, who comes from Kutch, Pralaj ji comes from Malwa, you know, Lakhanda comes from Bengal. So we have artists from all across the length and breadth of this country. The number of people who come and listen has been just increasing. Every year it's a greater number. Every venue is packed. We don't have a single event which is not packed to the rafters. And we also do a lot of closed events. So which are not open to public, they're done in institutions. So for example, in Dongri, Imwarkhari, where the children's home is. And so we do an event there every year. The Happy Feet Foundation, we did an event with their children. So we do a lot of closed events as well, which is for people who are not amongst us, who by whatever, for whatever reasons, are not outside.
The going hasn't been easy, and organizing a festival of this scale requires extensive organizing and performing. What really helps is that everyone participates with full fervor. All their events are packed with people who come from all walks of life.
I think fundraising is the biggest challenge, because we don't want to reach out to corporates. We want to celebrate the poets. Actually, more than that, it's just that because when people even donate you even 50 rupees, no, they feel it belongs to them. It creates a sense of belonging, you know. And it is our festival. It's not like my festival or X company's festival. It's our festival. And all of these artists who are here today, and they are all from different parts of the country. The logistics of actually bringing them here, some of them have big troops. They are very happy to come, like Prelaji's troop, very happy to come here by train, don't want flight tickets. You know, that's, in a way, for us, that is really precious, because they join in our journey.
The future looks bright for the festival, and they are doing a much required job of bringing people together.
We really like to see it spread in more and more open places. We are really happy that many other cities have started taking up this initiative and doing small and large festivals, events. We are living in difficult times, and I hope somewhere this festival does the job of a little healing, a little sharing, and sharing of love. And I found that in the words of poets like Kabir, maybe there is that space where we can meet and become a community.
Festivals like this help bring these important words and ideals alive, while at the same time bringing people together, and we hope that the journey continues.